Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. How many are glad to be in the house of the Lord tonight? Come on, jump up to your feet tonight. We got more folks coming in just a little bit, but we're going to go ahead and enter into the presence of the Lord today. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, jump up to your feet and let's praise the Lord today. Come on, put your hands together like this. Come on. We're going to go back old school for just a few minutes. Come on, like this. Well, victory is mine, victory is mine, victory today is mine. Well, I told Satan to get thee behind, victory today is mine. Come on, somebody say victory is mine,
victory is mine,
yes, victory is mine,
victory today is mine.
I told Satan, I told him,
get thee behind. Victory today is mine.
Joy is mine.
Joy is mine. Joy is mine. Joy today is mine.
Come on, say, I told Satan, I told him,
get thee behind.
Joy
today is mine.
Victory.
Victory is mine.
Victory is mine.
Victory is mine. Victory today is mine.
Yeah, I told Satan, I told it,
get thee behind. Victory today is mine.
Well, peace is mine. Peace is mine.
Peace today is mine. I told him, get thee behind. Peace today is mine.
Oh, say victory is mine.
Victory is mine.
Victory is mine. Victory, is mine. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, I told him,
get thee behind. Victory today is mine.
I told Satan,
I told it, get thee behind.
Healing
today is mine.
Let's do that one more time. Come on.
Healing is mine.
It's mine.
Healing is mine.
It's mine.
Healing today is mine.
Well, I told Satan, I told it,
get thee behind.
Healing
today is mine.
Victory is mine. Come on, say.
Oh, victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine.
Well, I told Satan, I told it,
get thee behind.
Oh, victory today is
mine. I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood.
Come on.
I know it was the blood for me.
Yes, it was. One day when I was lost, he died upon the cross. And I know it was the blood
for me.
Come on, help us sing that. Well, I know it was the blood.
Well, I know it was the blood.
I know it was the blood
for me.
Come on, somebody help us tonight. One day when I was lost, Jesus died upon the cross,
and I know it was the blood for me.
Well, I know
it was the blood.
I know
it was the blood.
I know
it was the blood for me.
Well, one day when I was lost, and Jesus died upon the cross,
and I know it was the blood for me.
Hey,
victory is mine. Victory is mine.
Victory today is mine. Well, I told Satan.
I told Satan.
I told him,
get thee today is mine.
I told Satan
to get thee behind. Victory today is mine.
Well, I know it was the blood.
I know it was the blood for me. My chains fell off, my heart was free.
Sing this with us.
Oh,
awestruck wonder, Lord. Every time I hear the mention of your great name, Lord. Jesus, your name.
Those hands and worship him in this hour. Jesus, you're the cup that won't run dry. Your presence is heaven to me. Come on, sing that to him tonight. Your presence,
your presence.
Oh, Jesus. treasure of my heart and of my soul. It's in my weakness that you are merciful. Redeemer of my past and present wrong. You are the holder of my future days to come.
Oh, your presence.
The Lord.
you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Is heaven to me, oh Jesus, and oh
Jesus.
Come on, say, your presence is I know.
Your presence is heaven to me.
Say,
oh Jesus.
We say, your hands and worship him all over this house. Your presence is heaven to me.
Oh, my Jesus.
Come on, let's worship him.
Oh, Jesus.
Glory to God. Your presence.
Worship.
Come on and give the Lord a hand praise in this house. Hallelujah. Come on, why don't you just worship him? Why don't you just throw those hands up and just worship the Lord in this house? Come on, why don't you forget about who you're standing next to? Slip those hands up to an almighty God tonight. Open up your mouth and just worship him. Just bless him. He's worthy. He deserves your worship. He deserves your praise. He deserves it tonight. Come on, sing it. I will give you all. Come on, lift your voice, lift your praise tonight, lift your worship tonight, all over this house. Lift your voices and magnify him. Come on, lift your voices and magnify the King, magnify the Lamb of Glory. He deserves it tonight. He deserves it tonight. Hallelujah. 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 Jesus, have your way,
have
God.
Your way, Lord.
We came to worship you. We came to magnify you. We came to love on you tonight, God. We'll extend our hands toward heaven. We'll lift our voices. We'll lift our praise. And we'll establish a chair that you can sit in, God. Come and sit in our praise. Sit in our worship tonight. We're going to give it to you tonight, God. It belongs to you. It's all yours. It's 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 yours.
Hallelujah, you
Hands up one more time. Come on, slip those hands up one more time. We lift our voices. We lift our praise. We lift our worship. It all belongs to you. 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 I'll never know how much it costs. I'll never know how much it costs. I'll never know
how much it costs.
I'll never be great. Come on, lift your voice. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I won't ever know how much it costs. I'll never know how much it costs. But I will be grateful. 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 God, I'm grateful. God, we're grateful.
Come on, church, there's waves of glory. Come on, waves of glory. Waves of glory.
Never know how much it costs to see my sins on that cross. Never know how much it costs to see my sins upon that cross. So here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're all together love.
Let's receive Miss Rosa Carranza tonight. She's going to come minister to us in a beautiful praise dance. Amen.
Praise him. He prepared everything. If I've been having a struggle this week, yes, I do. I tried to make the whole dance team come, and I couldn't make it. And I feel bad. And I say, God, I didn't want to go by myself. And he say, the world won the dance, but I take you out of the world, and you got the call. And this is for a lot of women and men of God who got the calls. You got the call, so I do it for him. The name of the song is Magnify. Hopefully God touch your heart.
Thank you.
Let's give Sister Rosa a good hand tonight. Amen. She's from our Northwest Arkansas location. Come on, put your hands together. Let's give her a great hand tonight.
Yes, amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Amen. Well, Sister April, I'm glad to be in this prophetic conference. I'm telling you, last night has been powerful. This morning was powerful. God has just been moving tremendously in the house of God.
I'm going to tell you something. Pastor Angela, you rocked my whole world last night. You didn't rock part of it. You rocked the whole thing, sister, from top to bottom. And if you weren't here last night, well, you missed it. But Thankfully, you can get a CD or a DVD of it.
Yes.
We'll get to that in a minute.
So yes, and if you weren't here this morning, you missed Prophetess Christy. Amen. Preached a powerful word from God. I'm telling you, two dynamic words. We're looking forward tonight to what the man of God has to deliver. Is anybody ready to hear the word of God in this house?
Amen.
Right before the man of God comes, we have a few announcements we want to present to you this evening. Don't forget, Saturday morning, tomorrow morning, Pastor Ramiro, would you stand? Would you mind to turn the house lights on? Thank you. Pastor Ramiro, all the way from Monterrey, Mexico, is going to be preaching in the morning right here. If you have not picked up your tickets for the breakfast, be sure and pick up those tickets to be a part of our breakfast. It's at 8:30 in the morning. We're going to have a tremendous time here in the house of God. Don't miss being a part of it.
Amen. Amen. Also tomorrow afternoon at 2 o'clock, from 2 to 4, we're going to have the School of the Prophets with our Apostle Bobby Hogan and Prophet Sean Strong, who is well aware of what's going on now. And I know that it's going to be an awesome time, so you want to be a part of that. It's going to be a time of teaching, and so you're going to get some instruction there. 2 to 4 tomorrow here in the sanctuary. I also want to invite you to come to us to the land of Israel. We're going to leave September the 23rd. We just got a couple weeks left, and it's not too late for you to go.
Not too late.
If you're interested in going, you can go from September 23rd to October 3rd. There's brochures in the back. We would love to have you. How many are going to Israel this year? Raise your hand. My hand's held high. I'm so excited. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, come and go with us, and we're going to have a wonderful time. It is going to be the fourth blood moon that Israel is going to be able to see. And the Feast of Tabernacles. So we're going to have a great time while we're over there. You should come and be a part of it too.
Amen. Going to be a tremendous time. Tonight, can we put our hands together and welcome everyone watching us by internet tonight? They're streaming in from all over the world. All over the world watching us. Can you just give them a good wave tonight? Tell them you're glad. If you would, cameramen from our blast off room, just get a good pan of the audience and wave to them tonight. Let them know that we're so glad that they've tuned in to be a part of this service, to be a part of this conference. God is doing strategic things in this hour, and we're so glad our streaming family has tuned in to bless us. Wherever you're watching us from, whether you're watching us from Czechoslovakia or Jamaica or India, whatever nation, or you're watching us from Alabama, amen. We're so glad you tuned in to be a part of this prophetic conference, and I want you to stay right there where you are. God's got a miracle for you tonight. You've tuned in the right night, and God's got something powerful in store for you. Don't miss next Sunday, September the 13th. Prophet Benny Baker is going to be right here at Christ for the World in Fort Smith, preaching behind this pulpit. Powerful man of God who God used tremendously in this ministry, prophesied this church, that we were going to walk into this church. A powerful man of God is going to be here the 13th. So don't miss being a part of that service. It's going to be life changing.
It really will. I mentioned earlier that if you missed the service last night or this morning, that you really missed it. But you know what? You don't have to miss it, because we have CDs, DVDs, and again this year we're offering the MP3 player. How many of you are familiar with an MP3 player? Raise your hand. Let me see. Okay, good. If you're not, they're really easy. But what we're going to do for you is we're going to download all the messages from camp meeting. You're going to get them all. They're going to be on this little contraption right here, and all you have to do is plug in your headphones, and you're ready to go. I told folks last camp meeting, if you're walking through Walmart, plug it in. Get a fresh word from God.
You can shout in Walmart.
You can exercise. Listen to your MP3 player. Anyway, it's a great opportunity. CDs, DVDs, MP3 player.
Amen. God is good. Don't you just love the word of God? Amen. Love hearing the word of God. I've been trying to train my ear to hear. The Bible says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. I'm telling you, we got to put the word of God in our ear and let it get in our spirit. And so we want to encourage everyone to watch us on Periscope. Miss April, could you tell us about Periscope?
Well, amen. I sure can.
Amen.
How many of you have a smartphone in the house? Anybody? Anybody? Great. Wonderful. I'm glad that you do. You can go to your app store right now or after church. How about after church?
After church.
And download the Periscope app. And see that little contraption, that little picture right there? Yes, that's what you're looking for. And you can follow Bobby Hogan. You have, these are all on the back table, so I'll give you step-by-step instructions. But basically what it is your phone's going to give you an alert, and it says Bobby Hogan is live right now. And you can touch that, and all of a sudden you see his anointed face.
You get off the phone, you get out, you quit
texting.
Yeah,
you stop everything else.
Stop doing everything else and click that Periscope.
You say, oh, wait, I got to go because my apostle is on live right now, and he's got a fresh word. And you hit that, and there's your apostle, and he's given a fresh word from God. And I don't know about you, but he's given some words right on time.
Yes.
I don't know how he knows. I know it's the Spirit of God, and he gives a word that I needed right at that moment. So it's free. You can't beat free. So pick up one of these on your way out. It'll help you.
Amen. I love it. He's a man of God, a man of prayer, and I love the fact that he can hear from God. He's heard from God concerning my life. If he's heard from God concerning your life, can we honor our apostle tonight? Let him know that we love him. We appreciate the gift that he is. Come on, you ought to stand to your feet and celebrate God's man, God's vessel. He's God's visionary. Come on, come on, honor our apostle tonight. Amen, hallelujah. He's the man that God has placed in our life with the prophetic word. Amen, that's caused us to be to where we are tonight. Amen, you may be seated. Amen. Just a couple of more announcements we want to make tonight. Don't forget, if you have not picked up his latest books, the first one is entitled Operating in the God Kind of Faith. According to Mark 11:23, powerful revelation of how to operate in God's faith. God has a kind of faith that he operates in. And so you want to get that faith in your spirit to have what he has. So I encourage you to pick up that book, Powerful Revelation. And this next one is entitled The Goodness of God. God wants to bless his people. I want to read the back of this book. In this book, you will learn about the goodness of God and how many will turn to God in these last days because of his goodness, not because of his judgment, but because of his goodness. The story of the cross declares not the judgment of God, but the goodness of God. When the first Adam fell, man went under a curse. God's goodness, not his judgment, caused him to robe himself in flesh and come to earth as the second Adam. A powerful revelation. You got to pick that book up. It will bless your life tremendously. And the third one is Walking in Divine Favor. How many wants to walk in divine favor in your life? How many believes that God can take you into a season? The Bible says this is the set time to favor Zion. If anybody believes that God's getting ready to favor your life, just wave your hands at me and declare, God's getting ready to release some supernatural favor in my life. Somebody shout favor. Come on, shout it like you mean it. Shout favor. Oh, give the Lord a praise in this house. Amen.
One more thing about the books. There's a conference special on the books. How many like a good blue light special every now and then? Glory. For this conference, the books are normally $10 each, but for this conference, you can get three books. Everybody say three books.
Three books.
Three books for $20. That's a great, great deal.
Great deal.
Listen, because you're getting great revelation. You can't put a price on revelation. You can't put a price on getting a breakthrough. So anyway, I wanted to let you know about that blue light special we got going on.
Amen. I love something the man of God, Pastor Bill Winston, said. He said one of the first things that God gave man was information. Before he gave him a wife, before he gave him a job, God gave him information. My people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. It's the information we don't have that is destroying our lives. Stop by the tape table, pick up some word, put it in your spirit, and let God change your life. We're going to receive our offering tonight in your seat. When you come in, there should have been an envelope in your seat. And we want to encourage everyone to give tonight in this offering. And on the back of the envelope, it says, if you're interested in our upcoming trip to the Holy Land, if you'd mark that there, if you'd like to be added to the prophetic text blast, every day our apostle sends out a prophetic word that the Lord speaks to him, whether he's in his prayer closet or wherever he is, the man of God, and the Lord speaks to him and gives him a prophetic word. He shoots that prophetic word across the text message, and you receive receive it wherever you are. If you'd like to be a part of that and you're not, please put your phone number there. If you'd like information about being a part of our dream team, of Apostle Hogan's dream team, please mark that there. Or if you'd like more information, if you're a church, you're a ministry, and you'd like to come under our umbrella, under our 501c, Christ for the World International, if you'd like to be a part of that, please check that and we'll get in contact with you and let you know the needed information that you're going to need to know. I'm so grateful tonight. God has blessed my life. I'm a product of a prophetic word. I'm a product of the prophetic word. I'm a product of this ministry. I love this ministry. I love being a part of this ministry. I love what God has taught me through this ministry and listening to the prophetic word, allowing that word to get in my spirit. One of my favorite testimonies is when I first came into the ministry and I first started listening to the man of God, I moved into an apartment. The apartment didn't have anything in it. And the man of God said, if you'll learn how to give and prophesy, prophesy to an empty room, prophesy to empty places, and you'll see God manifest those things. And so I began to prophesy. I began to give, and I began to prophesy. I started out giving my $5, but I believe God with my $5. And I'm telling you, God has blessed my life. And over the time, I saw God bring so much stuff into my possession as a result of listening to the word of God and allowing that word to get in my spirit. You're sowing into a great ministry tonight. You're sowing into a ministry that is literally touching the world. So I want to encourage every one of you to give tonight as God has blessed you. Everyone standing to your feet, if you would. Amen. I want the musicians to prepare to bless us in a good number on the instruments. Bring your seed tonight. Place it upon the altar, asking everybody to give tonight. And if you have any requests, please be sure and mark that on the back of the envelope. God bless you as you give. Amen.
Bless the Lord with thee. Bless the Lord with thee. Bless the Lord with thee. Bless the Lord with thee.
Everybody sing it.
Hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on and bless the Lord.
Bless.
This place is charged. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I don't know if I can get through this service without being flat on my back. Wow, did you enjoy or did you feel God in the worship tonight? Pastor Gazaway, come greet everybody tonight. He slipped out. He's coming back in. Get a microphone for him. He'll be preaching in the morning. Brother Ramiro, would you come up and Abigail, come up real quick. I want Brother Ramiro to greet you. Also, he'll be speaking in the morning. But Pastor Gazaway, some of your church made it tonight. We're so glad. And last night, your wife preached. Amen. Greet everybody. So tell them what's on your heart for in the morning. 10:30, not 10, 10:30. Amen.
Amen. It is so good to be here, Apostle. Thank you for inviting us to be here. We're excited about being here. We're excited to be here with you. And yes, did we not enjoy last night? God is good in this house. I married me a fireball. Amen. And she's a tough act to follow. Praise God. But it's so good to be here. I'm excited about, sometimes we struggle to know what's going on in our lives at times, and we struggle to understand what the attack is all about. But I'm here to tell you that there is a reason that the attack has been out there upon us like it has. And I want you to come in the morning and find out what that's all about, and that you might understand who you really are. We need to know who we are, that we might know why are we up under this kind of an attack, and know that listen, I'm a type of person where I ain't waiting for somebody to get me out. I'm ready to do a jailbreak myself. I'm ready to get up and get out of this thing. You know, I sometimes get tired of church. I'm ready to do something off the chain just because I'm in a place where that I feel like it's time to arise and let our enemies be scattered. I'm ready to get up in the devil's grill because he's been up in mine long enough. Amen. You come on out and we're going to worship the Lord and have a good time in the morning. Find out what God's going to say to us. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, we're so honored to have Pastor Ramiro from Mexico, his wife and beautiful daughter. Amen. They've been part of our ministry for many, many years. We were real young when I first started going to Mexico. How old are you now? 62. So you would have been about 22 or 23 when I first started going. Because I was young. Was she even born? Mm-hmm. Was she even born? Yeah. Barely? Barely. Amen. Now, let me tell you, when you honor a foreigner, the Bible calls them foreigners, some of them another nation, God will honor you. As I said this morning, you need to come tomorrow. Not only will you get a good southern breakfast and chocolate gravy and all that other stuff, but you'll get blessed for just honoring somebody from another nation that God sent to our nation. So you need to be here tomorrow just for that purpose. Sister Dickerson, would you stand? She'll be at the back in the vestibule with the tickets. Everybody see her waving back there? Amen. They're only $8 for adults and $4 for children. And we'll have breakfast in the fellowship hall to my right, and then we'll come in the sanctuary. Brother Ramiro, greet everybody.
Amen. Everybody, it's a blessing for me to be here because last year, I was here. I remember the blessing we received from God. But this year is another year. Yeah? In the future is mejor the last path. Okay. It's better. Quiero darle gracias a Dios.
I want to thank God
por la bendición de conocer este hombre de Dios.
For the blessing to meet this man of God.
Por más o menos unos 30 años.
About 30 years.
Y es una bendición para México.
And he's a blessing for all Mexico.
Reciban un abrazo, un saludo.
Receive a big hug.
De todos los pastores de México, principalmente de la ciudad de Monterrey.
From all Mexican pastors.
Ellos quisieran estar aquí.
From all Mexican pastors from Monterrey.
Pero no es posible.
They would like to be here, but it's not possible for them.
Sin embargo, estamos nosotros representándoles.
But we came as representing them.
Y quiero decirles.
And I want to tell you.
Que cada vez que estamos con ustedes.
That every time that we are with you.
Aquí en Forest Smith.
In Forest Smith.
Ellos están también con nosotros. Porque estamos en el mismo espíritu.
They are with us too because. because we are in the same spirit.
Y en esta conferencia,
so in this conference,
es un encuentro con Dios. Es un encuentro con Dios.
It's a time that we could have with God.
Y tenemos que aprovecharlo al máximo.
And we have to.
Tenemos que prepararnos.
We have to be prepared.
Estar listos.
We have to get ready.
Para recibir.
To receive.
La palabra de Dios.
The word of God.
A través del apóstol Bobby Hogan.
Through Apostle Bobby Hogan.
Dios les bendiga.
So God bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Right before I open the word, we have Sister Amber. Would you come? And she is going to, she slipped out. She has the list of those getting ordained. So Isaiah, would you come on up here and call the names of these who are going to be ordained? We have four wonderful men of God. Probably the first time ever we don't have any women. We have all men tonight being ordained from different places, different states. I believe four different states, four different men of God. And so would you call the names of those being ordained? Those that are being ordained, if you would come stand right here at the front facing me, and then we will proceed with our ordination.
Pastor Dwayne DeBrowse. Pastor Gregory Mostella. Pastor Harry Cruz. And Minister Jeff Hall.
Wow, come on, give the Lord a good hand. Wow, four great men of God up here tonight. You know, I've said before, something I heard somebody say the other day, they told their son, if you can do anything else, go ahead and do it. If you can't do anything else, then you're in ministry. I couldn't do anything else. I'd be the worst hamburger cooker in the world. I don't care what I tried to do. I would not be very good at it. My wife told me one day, she said, if you wasn't preaching, I couldn't live with you no time. Come on, somebody. It's my DNA. These men of God have been called by God, and ministry is in their DNA. Paul said to Timothy, and Paul had been beaten, he had been in jail, and he had been stoned by church folks, and all kinds of persecution. And so he's getting ready to leave this world, and you would think he would say to Timothy, run from the ministry, son. Get in a real estate business. Get in the car lot business, camel business in those days. But instead, he said, preach the word. Be instant in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. For the time will come, they will not endure sound doctrine. But after their own selves, heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. All I can say tonight is preach the word. Don't preach what's politically correct. Preach what's biblically correct. We have a girl tonight, a young lady in the state of Kentucky that is sitting in jail. She is a Pentecostal. She is sitting in jail because she refused to sign the certificate for same-sex marriage. She's sitting in jail tonight. And you know the sad thing is when she refused to sign for same-sex marriage, they tried to pull up her past. And it really backfired on them. They found out she had been married three times, had some babies out of wedlock or whatever. So they hit her with it hard. She said, that was before I give my life to Jesus Christ. Come on, somebody. When you preach what's biblically correct, it may get you in trouble, especially in this generation. What started in Kentucky with this young lady refusing to sign the certificate for marriage is just the beginning. Don't be surprised if it's not somewhere in the future that if we refuse to marry two people of the same sex, if we're not sitting in jail. Come on, somebody. Well, all I know is if I go to jail, we're going to have revival in jail. And then we probably have a jailbreak. But you got to take a stand for what's right. And to be honest, people are looking for someone that will take a stand for what's right. Even if they don't agree, they want somebody that don't apologize all the time. Even today in the political realm, those running for office of president, how many times have somebody said something or done something and then the opposite, you know, the people that believe opposite made such a noise, they come back and apologize. And those that have not apologized, that just said what they meant, whether it was right or wrong, but just said what they felt and didn't apologize, they're the ones that are soaring in the polls. People are tired of wimps in the political realm, and they're sure tired of wimps in the church realm. Oh, I could tell we're going to have some church tonight. I could just go ahead and preach right now. Somebody give God a praise. I feel the Holy Ghost. Get on your feet and praise Him. Hey! I want everybody to remain standing. We're going to ask all of those that are part of our fellowship, Prophet Sean, would you and Pastor Gazaway get the anointing oil? And if you would come, all of you that are part of the fellowship, if you would come at this time, these two men of God are going to anoint their hands, and they're going to anoint these men of God. And all of you that's in the fellowship, come in behind them if you would, all over the house. I don't need to ask you twice. I want to get in the Word. I'm wound up right now. So come on, amen, quickly, all over the house, all of you in the fellowship. Amen. I'm going to pray a prayer. Amen. Men of God, would you anoint them? And I want all of you over the house to stretch your hands this way, and let's pray. You don't know who's up here tonight. They may be the next Jimmy Swaggart, Billy Graham, Smith Wigglesworth. Come on, I feel something in the house tonight. Amen. Anointing them is in the book of Acts. Hallelujah. Father, we come to you tonight all over the house. Let's pray. In the name of Jesus, these men have been set aside for such a time as this. Brought into the kingdom. Oh, yes, Lord. God, tonight as they publicly stand before this crowd of people and say, I have been called to preach the word. I have been called. Lord, I ask you for a special anointing upon their life. Lord, I thank you tonight that they're going to go where I never went. They're going to preach like I never preached. They're going to win souls like I never won. Lord, I thank you for a double portion. Anointing upon these people. Upon these men of God. Oh, God, something's turning tonight. Somebody praise Him. Somebody praise Him. Somebody praise Him. This is hell's greatest fear. That God will raise up men of God. And God will raise up women of God. That will preach the truth. For the truth sets you free. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 As they sing a song, Isaiah, I want all of you ministers to come by, shake their hands, just come around to the left and come by and shake their hands and welcome them into the fellowship, amen, Christ with the World Fellowship. Welcome them, amen. And you that are in the house, put your hands together and give the Lord a praise for these men of God that are in the house. As April and Isaiah sings another hallelujah song, I feel a praise in the house.
Victory is mine. Today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Oh, victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine.
I told Satan,
you can get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Victory, victory is mine. Victory is mine. Oh, victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Victory is mine.
Victory is mine.
Victory today is mine.
I told Satan,
get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Joy is mine. Joy is mine. Joy is mine.
Joy today is mine.
I told Satan, get thee behind. Joy today is mine. Peace is mine.
Peace is
mine. Oh, come on, why don't you put those hands
peace
together now?
Today
somebody
is mine.
Ought to give God a praise. I told Satan,
I told it.
Get thee behind. Today is mine.
Oh, victory is
victory,
victory
is mine.
Victory is mine.
Oh yeah.
Victory today is mine.
I told Satan, you can get thee behind.
Victory today is mine.
Hey. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine.
One more time.
Victory is mine.
Victory.
Victory is mine.
Oh,
victory today is mine.
I told Satan,
get thee behind. Victory today is mine.
Give the Lord a praise.
Woo!
Hallelujah. Well, one more time.
Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine.
I told Satan. I told it.
Well, somebody ought to shout.
Victory today.
Somebody ought to jump. Hallelujah.
Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind.
Victory today is mine.
Give the Lord a hand, a clap of praise, and you may be seated. Thank you, Jesus. Turn in your Bibles to Amos 9. Please leave everything like it is in the sound room. Thank you. Amos chapter 9. Woo! Thank you.
just excuse me for just 60 seconds. Take a 30-second praise break. Go ahead, Brother Sam. Prophesy on that organ. Come on, prophesy on those drums. Some of you know you want to get out of the aisle and dance. Why don't you just go ahead? If you was out there in the world, you'd be dancing right now. Some of y'all 5 years ago was out in the world dancing. No, come on, don't be more fanatical for the world than you are for the Lord. Come on, just take three minutes. Come on, just get out and dance if you want to dance. That's right. Go ahead. Some of y'all ain't danced in a long time. That's what I'm talking about. I feel another wave. Woo! Thirty more seconds. Got the joy. You're not in a dead church tonight. In a Holy Ghost, devil-aiding, sin-killing, spirit-moving, sanctified, blood-bought revival church service. Somebody might shout their wig off tonight. Somebody's false teeth might fly out. I feel another way.
Soul saving. What kind of church this is? A sanctified church. What kind of church this is?
a sanctified church. What kind of church this is? A sanctified church. We got hand clapping, hand clapping, hand clapping, hand clapping, toe tapping, toe tapping, hand waving, soul saving, church of the living God. What kind of church this is? A sanctified church. What kind of church this is? A sanctified church. We got hand clapping, hand clapping, hand clapping, hand clapping, toe tapping, toe tapping, toe tapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping, hand waving,
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 soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
church of the living God.
What kind of church this is?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church this is?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church this is?
A sanctified church.
We got hand clapping,
toe tapping,
hand clapping,
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 toe tapping,
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 hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
soul saving,
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 church of the living God. What kind of church this is? A sanctified church.
What kind of church is this?
A sanctified
church. What kind of church is this?
A sanctified church.
We got hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
soul tapping,
soul tapping,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
church of the living God.
What kind of church is this?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church is this?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church is this?
It's a sanctified church.
We got hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
toe tapping,
soul tapping,
toe tapping,
soul tapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
hand waving,
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 soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
church of the living God.
What kind of church is this?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church is this?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church is this?
A sanctified church.
We got hand clapping,
hand clapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
hand waving,
hand waving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
toe tapping,
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 hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
church of the living God.
A sanctified church.
What kind of church this is?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church this is?
A sanctified church.
We got hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
church of the living God. God.
Yeah. church this is? A sanctified church. What kind of church is this? A sanctified church. What kind of church this is? A sanctified church.
We got hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
hand waving,
hand waving.
Say hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving.
Soul saving,
soul saving,
church of the living God.
What kind of church is this? A sanctified church. What kind of church is this? A sanctified church. What kind of church is this?
It's a sanctified church. We got hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
toe tapping,
hand waving.
Hand waving,
hand waving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
church of the living God.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Hey. Hey. Hey.
Hey. Come on, put those hands together.
this church one time. Woo! Glory to God. Over in that corner. Dance your way right into a new destiny, new level with God. Come on, this, go ahead. This service is out of control by the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody just go ahead and get what God's got for you. The agenda is gone. The Holy Ghost is here. Give the Lord one more hand clap of praise in the house. Turn around and just bless somebody in the name of the Lord. If you feel like prophesying to somebody, prophesy to them. If you want to pray for them, pray for them. If you feel like giving them a scripture, come on, just bless somebody. Bless somebody there by you in the name of the Lord. Come on, bless them, bless them. Bless somebody. Hug somebody, hug somebody. Encourage somebody. Somebody's coming out. Somebody's coming out. Somebody's coming out. Somebody's coming out. Somebody is coming out. Somebody's coming in, somebody's coming in. Somebody come out and now they're coming in. Somebody's coming in. I feel another wave, I feel another wave. I feel another wave. I feel another wave. On my right, going right on through the middle to the left, I feel another way. told you it's out of my hands.
What kind of church is this?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church is this?
A sanctified church.
Oh, a sanctified church. We got hand clapping,
toe tapping,
hand waving,
soul saving,
hand clapping,
toe tapping,
hand waving,
soul saving,
hand clapping,
toe
tapping,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
hand waving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving.
Soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving,
soul saving.
Church of the living God.
What kind of church is this?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church this is?
A sanctified church.
What kind of church this is?
A sanctified church.
We got hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
hand clapping,
soul tapping,
soul tapping,
hand waving,
hand waving,
soul saving,
soul saving.
Church of the living God. You may be seated in his presence. Tell you something, there's an open heaven right over here between these seats and that wall. If you need something from God, I challenge you to walk through that area. Don't be surprised if you don't fall out, but there's an open heaven right over there. I felt it when I walked through. New body parts are being created. God's releasing new body parts for people right now. Oh my God.
angels are walking among you. My God, my God. People are falling under the power. People are getting drunk. People are having visions right now. I see a new anointing right now falling on Prophet Sean Strong. You'll never be the same. Thank you.
hello.
There's a sweet anointing
spirit in this place,
flowing down from heaven above. There's a sweet spirit in this place, and it flows from heaven above. There's a sweet spirit in this place. Flows from heaven above. Sweet Spirit, sweep over my soul as you flow.
Then sings my
soul, my Savior God, to thee.
How great thou art!
How great thou art! How great thou art! Sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
How great thou art.
Oh, how great thou art.
Everybody sing it tonight all over the house.
How great.
Come on,
thou
let's
art.
Sing it to him. Then sing. My
soul. Oh, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
How great thou art.
How great thou art.
How great thou art.
How great thou art.
Thou art.
How great thou art. How great thou art.
Let's lift our voices one more time and worship him in the sanctuary tonight. In his presence, we go into eternity. In his presence, we go out of the time zone. And we go into the glory zone. And in that song, there is no time. 30 minutes, an hour seems like moments. As we're in his presence, as we're in his glory, hallelujah to the Lamb of God. How great
thou art.
How great
thou art.
Oh,
to thee.
Good job, Mama.
How great thou art, how great thou art.
One more time, how great.
How great thou. My spirit's flowing here. Come close, oh, come close. For my spirit's flowing here. Oh, oh, come close. Come close to me. For I will say unto you, come close to me. For I will say unto you, I'm gonna set you free. For this is the hour of my blessings. This is the hour of my joy. Oh, oh, come close. Oh, come close. Oh, my spirit's flowing here. Yes. Oh, my spirit's flowing here. Won't you please come close. Oh, come close. Oh, come close. Drawing you here. Open up your heart to me. Open up your heart to me. These aren't tears of pain. These aren't tears of sorrow. But these are tears of joy. Please come close. Come close. I want you to come close. These aren't tears of pain. These aren't tears of sorrow. These aren't tears of joy. Open up your heart to me. Open up your heart to me. Please come close. Please come close. For I'm healing you. I'm healing your seed. I'm healing your generation. For I broke the rules. I broke the pain. I broke poverty. I broke the back of sickness. I broke the back of disease. Please come close. Please come close. Please come close. Come close. Come close. Come close. See, my blood still works. My blood still flows. The enemy can't cross the bloodline. The enemy can't cross the bloodline. This is your season of freedom. This is your season of joy. This is your season of blessing. This is your season of the blood. The season of the blood. The season of the blood. Please come close. Please come close. Oh, come close. Oh, come close. Oh, come close. It's the season of the blood. 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 My blood still works. My blood still sets free. My blood still heals. My blood will set you free. Oh, come close. For I am drawing you, I am drawing you, I am drawing you. Redig the wells, 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 redig the wells. I've got power there, I've got peace there, I've got joy there, I've got blood there. It's the season of the blood, the season of the blood. Come close. Oh, come close. For my spirit is drawing you. So please come close. Please come close. For 1,000 shall fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but none shall come nigh your dwelling. Please come close. Please come close. Please come close. Come close. Come close. Don't run from me, but run to me. Run to me. Run to me. I'll stay right here. I'll stay right here. Just come close, come close.
If anyone has a prophetic song or a prophetic word, feel free to come right now and to the front and sing it or speak it forth. Just move quickly. If anybody has a prophetic word, prophetic song, feel free to come to the front here in front of the pulpit. Amen. Stay in this flow.
To let you know that I feel the presence of God so strong here, just like everyone else. But he's saying that this is why some people have the Holy Spirit and the gift so great and his anointing so strong is in these moments of surrender, as we watch everybody fall to your knees and just the way that the Spirit is moving and the surrender that everybody is just letting go and letting loose and giving it to God. And it's just so beautiful, and it's not often enough. But I just feel that God is saying, this is how you'll get it. This is what, or the way to receive it and to move forward through it.
Amen. Beautiful. Somebody else, just quick. That was right in order, nothing out of order. If you get out of order, we'll set you down. But if you have something, you feel free to speak it quickly.
I heard God say that he's calling out some Nehemiahs, people that are not afraid to step up and pray for this land. And I heard God also say he's calling out some Ananias to lay hands on some people that's going to further spread the gospel. Nehemiah was a king's cupbearer, but he felt led to pray for Jerusalem, to pray for his nation. He felt the urge to call his family out and say, we have sinned, we have fallen. But he prayed and helped build the wall back up in Jerusalem. It's time that we rise up like Nehemiah and pray for this land. Pray for Israel. Pray for America, because America's in bad shape. We need to rise up and be like that Nehemiah. And don't care where we come from, but pray, God, please help America fall on our face and cry like he did. One of the greatest prayers in the Bible is in Nehemiah 1. We need to call out to this, say, God, help this nation. For if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear a voice from heaven and I will forgive their land.
Amen. Beautiful. Somebody else. Just quickly.
The Lord wanted me to tell his people to come to his house, to come to his mercy, to come to the needs that you have. He wants you to come and be humble to him. Yes, only the Lord.
Okay, somebody else, quickly, somebody else. Pastor Edna, feel free to come. Come on, two or three of you. We're not wasting a second time. We're in a flow of the river.
For the Lord said to tell my people, this night you have behold the heavens open up unto you. For you have began to see the latter rain and the former rain come together. God said there will be a great increase of my presence. There will be times in your midst that no man will stand. God said, I'm pouring out the rain. The rain is falling out of the heavens, said God.
I seen a vision, as Brother Bobby said, it was over in the corner, and I seen this beautiful bride. Her veil was so long. And as y'all was going over there, you were going under her veil. And as you were coming out, the things that bothered you the last week, see, the devil's coming quicker. I told somebody the other day, I said, Brother Bobby, the voice of the devil is so much louder than what it was a year ago. We are dealing with some demonic entities that knows their time is coming. But I've seen people coming out of that bride. And Brother Bobby, they were dressed like warriors. They come out with the stains from the past gone. I'm telling you, God is real. It ain't about the man of God giving you a word all the time, coming and laying hands on you and giving you everything. Sometimes we got to go under the veil. Sometimes we got to go under there and say, God, I'm not all that in a bag of chips. But we come out warriors. And I'm telling you, some of y'all tonight have got your combat boots on and you're ready for the enemy. You're ready to tell the devil, hey, what did she say last night? Defeat has not got the last word. Amen.
I want to confirm to that young man about building the wall. Last Sunday night, the Lord was in praise and worship in my room, and the Lord said, we're to go and we're to build a wall of love around the Christians, and we're to build a wall of prayer together, because we're going to need each other.
I just heard God say, he just wants us to love him. He said, love me. I'm still the sword and the shield. Love me. I'm still the strength, but I'm peace. Love me in your dark hours and your darkest nights. You still gotta love me. Love me through your hurt and your pain, through your disappointment, your heartache. love me. To focus under function, to function under focus is the same to me as long as you function. I'm still the man at the hill that gave the life. I'm still the baby in the manger. Love me. Love me beyond your wildest dreams. You still gotta love me. Love me in everything you do. Love me.
Somebody else? Come on, come, man of God. Come on.
I have a word for people in the workplace. In the last days, the Lord will pour out his spirit on all flesh, but he showed me he's going to pour it out through all of you. The anointing that Paul and Peter had, where Peter walked and his shadow touched people, he will give it to us all. Because when he pours out his spirit upon all flesh, he needs someone to pour it through. And I see someone working at Walmart. When you scan the items, the anointing will be on the things that you give them. I see someone in a call center. When someone calls you, the anointing will be in your voice. And they will speak in tongues when you talk to them. The Lord is saying that this is just the training grounds. These buildings are for training, but the mission is out there. And he will anoint all of you. The same anointing that is upon Apostle Hogan is available through the blood of Jesus. And his blood is strong enough to touch the world.
God, we just love you tonight. We just praise your name tonight, God. We just lift you up, God, in this house.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
We will not forget that you are good and real. And that you're really doing something in us tonight, God. Whether we feel it or not, whether we feel your presence or not. It's not about feeling. It's about knowing that you love us and knowing that your word is true, regardless of feeling. Thank you, Lord, for it.
Is there somebody else before we change the service? I feel like there might be about two or three more people real quickly have a word. Maybe first time ever to do it. Just obey the Lord. Amen. Wait in just a moment. Amen. Come on, Pastor Hill. Obey the Lord. Man of God. What he has to say, you can believe it. Hallelujah. Somebody else come while he's speaking.
We see John in the book of the Revelation and he's weeping. He's weeping because there's no one that is worthy to open the scroll. The scroll represents the future. He's weeping because the future involves the rapture of the church, the marriage supper of the Lamb. He's weeping because the future represents Jesus coming and setting up his kingdom for 1,000 years on planet Earth. He's weeping because of the future, and there's no one worthy to open up the scroll. And it is stopping the future of the new heaven and the new earth. He's weeping because there's no one that is worthy to open up the scroll, and so that New Jerusalem cannot come down. He's weeping because that there is no one that is there that is worthy. But the angel says, and he cries with a loud voice, "Behold, the Lion of Judah hath prevailed, and he is worthy to open the scroll." The angel takes the scroll, which represents time, and places it in the hand of the Lion of Judah. And the Lion of Judah holds time in his hand. Time is in his hand. He controls the future. He controls the time. He controls the season and the destiny of America, the destiny of this world, the destiny of ministries, the destinies of churches that is arising up with a sword in their hand. He controls destiny. The White House doesn't control destiny. The Congress does not control destiny. They do not say what is going to happen in the future. The Lamb holds time in his hand.
Praise the Lord.
Paula, come speak after Brother Sharp, please.
I was behind the drums, so I didn't really hear what the pastor had called the people to the wall for. But while I was on the drums and I was looking at him on the floor, he kneeled down and then he laid prostrate. When he laid prostrate, I looked over again. I saw all of the people on the wall. And I don't know if you've been praying about this or not, or been, it's been on your heart for expansion. But while I was looking at the wall and looking at you laying prostrate, I heard God say, I'm pushing out that wall. I'm pushing that wall out. I'm pushing that wall out because there's a people that is needing a fresh word. And for this region, there's a fresh word in this area. And you have a fresh word. And so they get ready for that wall. The people tonight, I saw them coming in agreement. And they was pushing that wall down for you. Now, I know people was getting blessed for their own reason. But God was using you to push that wall out. So get ready.
Amen. As I went toward the wall over there, I saw a river rising in this house. And I saw a unity come into the church. And as the unity came, the glory of God filled this house. And I seen the number 8. And we all know what 8 means. God's got some new beginnings. And it started today.
Send down your glory. Send down your glory. Cleanse these hands that we raise in this temple filled with praise. Send down your glory. Send down your glory. Our broken lives you can mend. If you would touch us once again, send down your glory. Send down your glory. Send down your glory. Cleanse these hands that we raise in this temple filled with praise. Send down your glories. How many is ready for some glory? Send down your glory. Our broken lives you can mend. If you would touch us once again, send down your glory. 'Cause he inhabits our praise. Let us stand in your presence. Open the holy of holies where you dwell. Send down your glory. Just say it with me. Send down your glory. Cleanse these hands that we raise in this temple filled with praise. Send down your glory. Send down your glory. Our broken lives you just mended. When we touch you once again, we love your glory.
Sandalama, sandama, kandama, sandaya. Amen. As
there one more before we change the service? The flow was so beautiful in the spirit that I have to be very sensitive. I don't want to go in the wrong direction. Be in church 3 hours and nobody leaves, just a handful of people leaves. Gotta be God in the house. Gotta be the glory in the house. Go ahead, Prophetess Christy, be our last one to speak a prophetic word.
As I was sitting there, I seen the worshiping angels. I seen cherubims and seraphims, and they were just all just flying around. And I began to hear the Lord say that there's an invasion of heaven. And that the heavens are invading the earth. And that there has been a shift in the atmosphere to where it's a breakthrough in the atmosphere. To where that the atmosphere is open, and it's like you can see the invasion of heaven coming closer to earth. And I began to hear, as the people were worshiping, I began to hear the sound of worship as a throne room worship. And I began to hear the Lord say that as we tap into the worship, that we will see a Shekinah glory to where that we become glory carriers. To where that we carry the glory of God. And when we go into a place, when we go into a store, or we go into a church to minister, or we go into a different area, that the glory will cause the area and the territories to shift and to begin to live again, to where the demonic activity will have to flee. To where even ministers that God is calling them to arise, to come up to a higher dimension, because he's wanting to impregnate you with a Shekinah glory, to where that when you go into a church or a area, you will deposit that glory there in that place. And God says to begin to listen. Listen. For I'm speaking. Listen. Clean out the clutter. Turn down the noise. Turn down the noise. Some of you have too much noise going on in your ears. Because God says to listen. I'm sharpening your spiritual ear. Listen to my voice.
Pastor DeWayne, come speak a word, please. It's first time to ever be at our conference. He got ordained tonight. He pastors in Des Moines. Loves the Lord. Just speak a word.
A couple months ago, the Lord gave me a vision of two angels. While I was sitting over here, she had brought up some angels, and I was contemplating whether I was going to say anything or not. But about 2 months ago, it's like the Spirit revealed to me that He began sending angels throughout the regions of the land, across this country. And darkness, deep darkness, has covered the earth. We know that. But at the same time, the light of God is going to shine. And these angels, what they were doing was they were sent on assignment. And I watched them as they were coming into our church in the Des Moines, Iowa area. And I was pleading with our congregation and pleading with the Lord that when they showed up on assignment to our place, that they would see a house of worship and a house that preached the truth without compromise, a house that would stand strong in the power of God and the glory of God, and would let the liberty of the Holy Spirit flow, and that when they went back to give the report to the Lord, that they would say, that's a place where your spirit is welcome. That's a place where the truth of the Word of God is being preached. That's a place where the liberty of the Holy Spirit is allowed to move and to breathe, and the fire of God can fall. And I felt honored as just the remnant. You know, I believe we're a remnant. I believe there's a remnant within the remnant of people around the world. And he was saying that this is a place. And I challenged our congregation to just heed the presence of God. See, when we come into these places, it's a building. It's surrounded with walls. But we are the church. And we're not a defeated church. We are a church that is alive because we serve the God of the living, not the God of the dead. He's alive and He's well. And He's in this place tonight. And as I was sitting there, and I gave that word because I felt the same thing, that's why I feel such a connection here with this ministry. And I'm honored to be part of what's going on. And because the angels of the Lord has come to this place and visited this place. And the scripture says, whose report are we going to believe? We're going to believe the report of the Lord. Amen. And we know that the power of God is moving. And I also want to say this as well, because there was so much going through me as I was sitting over here. He's stirring something in me about a message along the line of the men that walked with God. There's a lot of people that walk with God or claim to walk with God, men and women alike, but there's a lot of people that are not walking with God like God wants them to walk with Him. And He's raised up a people in this generation. See, we can talk about the days of old. We can talk about our heritage and all those things of the past, but this is a new day. This is an hour now. He's the God of the now and the God of the suddenlies. And we live in this day and this hour now. And we need God to move on our behalf now, greater than ever before. There was a day when God had people like Elijah and Elisha, the prophets and the prophetesses of old, where they didn't go and they didn't wait for God to say something, and then they spoke what God said. Sometimes they did, but in a lot of cases you'll see and you'll read in scriptures where they just commanded the word, and God obeyed the words that they were commanding to go forth. Why was that? Because they walked in a place with God. You're listening to me tonight. They walked in a place with God where the Spirit of God was so relevant into their life and their sensitivity to what God wanted to do and what God wanted to say, that when they spoke, the Spirit of God began to move. See, He didn't say, you know, in one situation to Elisha, the armies of Israel had come and they were prepared for war and they were getting ready for battle, and they they joined up with two other kings of the land, and what ended up happening was they got down to the river. And when they got down into the river area, the Bible says that the water was dried up. It was all dried up. See, they had all their weapons. They had prepared everything they needed to do, prepare for battle. But at the same time, they were dying of thirst. And Elisha told them, he said, you start digging some ditches. Start digging some ditches. And God's going to cause the water to flow. See, it's not time for us to sit back. It's time for us to stand up and rise to the occasion. It's not time for the church to be silent. It's time for the church to shout it from the rooftop and speak out. We're not ashamed of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. We're proud to be Christians today. And we're rising to the occasion. And God, see, there's two different ways you see in Scripture where the eyes of the enemy, you know that he goes around seeking whom he can devour. But the same time as the enemy is going around seeking whom he can devour, the eyes of the Lord are going throughout all the earth, seeking whose mind and heart is stayed upon him. And God is going to show himself strong on behalf of those whose mind and heart are stayed upon him, especially in these last days. And we will rise up and we will have a backbone, amen. We're not going to sit back. We're not a bunch of sissies. Jesus wasn't a sissy. I'm not a sissy. I know this man here is not a sissy. Amen. I know this man's not a sissy. And you're not a sissy. And we serve a God that is mighty and strong, amen. And he's going to move. He's going to move greater. Jesus said, greater things shall you do. We're living in the prophetic day where our ancestors, many of those in the past, they saw it and they longed to live in it. And we're living in it. We're going to see some of the greatest things this world has ever seen, because we're not going out in defeat. Amen. We're going out in a blaze of glory. Hallelujah. Praise God.
Come on, give the Lord a hand. Well, tonight, it's been a history-making service. Just think, you've been in a house where angels have been all over the place. And greater than that, God has been in the house. I prophesy that some of you, when you go to the restaurant tonight, people are going to look at you like you're an alien. Come on. I prophesy when some of you walk in that hotel, amen, you're going to change the atmosphere. You're going to change the atmosphere at McDonald's. Come on, somebody. You're carriers of the glory. And tonight there's a double portion that has been released. The glory of God has been in the house. At 8:30 in the morning, we're going to start right back. You're free to stay here all night if you want to in the presence of God. And then at 10:30, there's no telling what's going to happen as we gather back. And then tomorrow night, Brother Gassaway at 10:30, and tomorrow night, Prophet Sean Strong. My God, what an anointing. Wasn't that a powerful prophetic? I saw a new anointing hit him against that wall. And I prophesy tomorrow night he's going to preach like he never preached before. Amen. Amen. I want everybody to get an offering before we close, and I want to make sure some of the workers, the other envelopes that we use for the first offering, if someone could make sure that if somebody needs one. I want to share a little revelation before we receive the offering. The Lord spoke to me some time ago, and he said there's a revelation that's going to, I want to word it the right way. He said there's a truth that is going to be revealed on prosperity that's not been revealed. A little later, God spoke to me, and God said, he said, this truth is going to take you above 30, 60, 100 fold. It's going to take you into an unlimited fold. So I was wanting to know what the truth was. And the Lord spoke to me one day after that and said, the truth is simply sowing your seed in the glory. Sowing your seed in the glory. When you sow your seed in the glory, you break all limits, all barriers. You go into, let me give you an example. The five loaves and two fishes. I was going to preach about that tonight. This may be the first time in the history of our camp meetings, maybe the second time in 40 years I never preached when I was supposed to preach at a camp meeting, but I couldn't. You get mad at the boss. I'm real high right now. I don't have no driver tonight either. I don't hardly even feel no flesh. Even those days, I'm more spirit than I am flesh. I almost felt like Sister Gwen prophesied for the rapture, Christians were going to fly. I almost felt like if I put my hands out, I'd fly. But if I did, some of y'all would have a heart attack and go on to go. I don't want y'all to die yet, so I'm not going to try. 5 loaves and 2 fishes went into the hands of Jesus, who was the glory of God. And it multiplied. I wrote this down. I did a little study. Let me show you something. I will preach for a minute. 5 loaves and 2 fishes fed 5,000 men besides women and children, about 12,000 people. 12 basketfuls left over. If each person ate 2 fish apiece, and if they were spirit-filled, which they wasn't because the Holy Ghost hadn't come, but if they had been, they'd ate a lot more than two because church folks like to eat. If each person ate 2 fish apiece, that's 24,000 fish. 12 basketfuls left over. If each basket had 300 fish, that's an extra 3,600, making a grand total of 29,000. I'm sorry, minus the 2 fish the boy had, makes a grand total of 28,598 fish from 2 fish. Do you get that revelation? Ah, come on, somebody. Jesus took 2 fish. That little boy gave the 2 fish into the glory. He sold into the glory. And those 2 fish in about 10 minutes multiplied to 28,598 fish approximately. That's what happens when you sow into glory. I want to challenge you tonight to bring your seed and place here in front of the pulpit. If you need an envelope, you can lift your hand. Many of you need one because you already sowed in the first offering, so we have ushers on both sides that will help if you need an envelope. But I want to challenge, I'm going to tell you what I heard the Lord speak to me. This was before the service went like it did. The Lord said, challenge people to a $500 seed offering, so I'm going to be the first to sow 500. Then he said, many could sow 100. Many could sow 100. Right now, you are not sowing in an offering for 30, 60, or 100 fold. You're sowing in a glory, and you're sowing where it will go beyond 30, 60, 100, even beyond. It's no explanation to what happens. And when you sow in an atmosphere like we have right now, don't be unwise. Be wise. Take advantage of this moment. Some of you need to sow for your church, sow for your ministry, sow for your business, sow for your personal life. Could I have an envelope, please? I'm sowing 500. Amen. And that 500 will multiply probably within a matter of 7 days. That 500 will multiply. I'm at a faith rim right now. I was going to preach tonight, but I wasn't able. I'm at a faith rim I've never been in my entire life. I am in a faith rim that nothing shocks me, nothing surprises me. After this service, my faith rim is at another level. If your level's not 500, I know there's at least 3 that can sow 500 because the Lord spoke to me, and there's at least 20 that can sow 100. If it's not, you sow at what level you're at, whether it's 20, 10, 50, whatever it is. But don't be unwise. Take advantage of this moment. This offering's not for us, it's for you. It will go into the glory and many souls will be touched, whatever, as a result. But this offering's for your harvest. If you got that revelation, it'd be a big offering tonight. I hope you got it. I don't have a long time. I'm about to pass out. But I hope you're wise tonight. Bible talks about moments of opportunity, Kairos moment. If you've ever sowed, you need to sow tonight. Write a check, write it to Bobby Hogan Ministries. If you need an envelope, lift your hand. Teenagers, everybody needs to sow. I mean, I don't care if you're 5-year-old, you need to sow tonight if you're big enough to know what I'm saying. Bill Winston said a young man come to his church a while back that was 14-year-old that was a millionaire. Did you hear what I said? And he said he'd come out of the projects. a young black boy, he said, come to his church that was 14-year-old, that was a millionaire, that come out of the projects. You're not too young, and you're not too old to be a millionaire. I just heard the Lord say, somebody needs to sow out of your business and God to prove himself to you, your ministry, whatever. I don't have to pray. We pray because of tradition sometimes. Jesus in the tomb of Lazarus said, I know you already heard me, but I'm going to pray for their sake. Well, I'm not going to pray for your sake tonight. Amen. Man of God, I know you. I played that organ tonight. Amen. Brother Sharp, you've been on those drums. I may owe y'all a steak dinner. Amen. Can you do just another 5 minutes? Amen. Just worship. Amen. Worship. And everybody come bring your seed, your glory seed, and just place it here in front of the pulpit. Everybody participate. Everybody. Be wise tonight. This is the wrong envelope. I need the regular envelope, please. The regular envelope. Hallelujah. Yes, thank you. Keep those for tomorrow night or whatever. Thank you. Amen. Come on. Alamosando, la masanda. On your way out, be sure and get the ticket for the breakfast. Let's honor our missionaries. God will bless you for it. Amen. Stand to your feet all over the house. I want to ask you tonight, the Spirit of the Lord is still here, so strong. So if you're going to fellowship, could you fellowship in the vestibule? There may be people that just want to stay in His presence for a moment. Amen. Hallelujah. So fellowship in the vestibule, but let's keep this Holy Spirit. Let's keep this holy anointing in the house. I know that's hard for some of you because you're used to just talking, but let's honor the presence that's still here. If you want to stay around the front, you're welcome. You feel free to be dismissed. Hallelujah. Let's have the key of G, please. Amen. Through it all. I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Through it all, I've learned to depend upon His Word. Oh, through it all. I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Through it all, I've learned to depend upon His Word. Could you put a praise tape in the sound room? Put a praise and worship tape in. Through it all. Through it all.